So friends, we are continuing our chapter number one examples. Okay, so we have already covered all these topics, and even from the section number A, I have already covered till example number four. As of now, I am going to take example number five, right? As I've already explained, the reason being I'm explaining this example because there are certain tricks you need to know before solving the actual numericals, right? So in example number five is saying, in figure 1.7, okay, so let me just draw a figure first. So this figure is, let's say this is a roller, and this roller is resting at a surface. Let's say this is the surface, and this is saying x, this is y, and there are two forces are applying on this roller. One is F2 and another is F1, right? And this is the center of this roller. So this is the whole diagram what they are explaining. Now it's saying, in figure this, the roller of a diameter is 0.4 meter. So this is 0.4 meter. And is raised on a pavement XY, means this is resting on this point X and Y. Now is saying, if we apply force F1 and F2, and each of having a magnitude of 10 Newton, means F1 is equal to F2 is equal to 10 Newton, right? Means these two forces are equal. Then we need to compare the torque. Torque means moment of force. You need to compare. So there must be some difference. That's why we are comparing this. What is the difference? The difference is, if you can see the perpendicular distance of a point X, this one, for force F1 and F2, so perpendicular distance, if I say for F1, then this will be the complete diameter. So in F1, distance will be 0.4 meter. However, in case of F2, this is the half of the diameter. So in F2, the distance will be what? Half of the diameter, which is 0.4 meter by 2, and that is 0.2 meter, right? So the only difference, if I am applying the same force, is in the location, is in the place, is the point where I am applying that force, right? So now if I am going to compare this, then this will be the moment of force. Let's say F1 oblique moment of force F2, that will be force into distance. Let's say for in case of F1 and F2, and this will force into distance of second location. So F1 is what? F1 is, we already know, this is 10, okay? And that is also in case of F2, this is again 10. But distance in case of F1 is 0.4 meter. And in case of force 2 is 0.2 meter. And that's why this will become 2 by 1. So the comparison or the ratio of these two forces will be 2 by 1, and that is your answer. So the trick here is perpendicular distance of rotation X for F1 and F2, right? So from here, the trick is you need to find out the perpendicular distance. If you got this trick, that's the only trick to find out the distance correct. If you know this, you will be able to solve this question, right? So that's all about question number 5. Hope you are able to understood the logic, understood the trick. Let me know if you have any doubt. In next video, we will be seeing example number 6. Till then, bye bye and take care.